Day in the faith versus law debate, a 9-judge constitution bench of the Supreme Court will shortly commence hearing a batch of pleas on the entry of women and girls in places of worship across all religions. The completely new 9-judge bench, headed by Chief Justice CJI-Bobde, will hear a batch of 60 petitions. The legal scrutiny follows the Sabarimala judgment in favor of women entering the temple. While referring the matter to a larger bench, the 5-judge bench in November 2019 had said that the debate about the constitutional validity of religious practices like a bar on the entry of women was not limited to the Sabarimala case but also to mosques and Parsi temples. The court said that it was time to evolve a judicial policy to do substantial and complete justice. Let me now go across to our legal editor Utkarsh Anand as well as Neetu Regu Kumar, who's joining us live from Thiruvananthapuram. First of all, let me go across to Utkarsh. Utkarsh, what should we expect today from the court? What will it be looking at? Will the precedent just be of Sabarimala, or in this case, considering they are looking at all religions, how are they going to go about pronouncing this verdict?
Maha, there are many steps before this verdict is going to be pronounced. Okay. It's a 9-judge bench. Hmm. As you pointed out, it's a completely new judge bench. All the judges, they had not been associated with either the Sabarimala case or the other petitions which have been referred to in the reference order. Hmm. In November last year, the majority view said that the issue is not just limited to Sabarimala. There are restrictions on women's entering fire temples in Parsi religion. Hmm. We also have female genital mutilation practice in Daudi Bora community. Hmm. There are various other restrictions in mosques also. Hmm. All these issues need to be also adjudged by the Supreme Court on a larger wide scale, because you need to decide about interplay of articles 25 and 26 and the corresponding rights. On one hand, you have rights of a religious group to follow their own rituals, customs, traditions, which they say that it is integral to their way of practicing religion. On the other hand, you have women or even men in certain cases who have been asserting their fundamental right to equality, their fundamental right to pray. How do we assess, how do we judge, how do we juxtapose these two rights and then strike a balance? The Supreme Court will also need to, in fact, consider the issue that whether it is permissible at all for the Supreme Court to decide what is integral part of religion or not. By a 7-judge bench in 1950s, the Supreme Court had said it is better left to the community to decide what is essential religious custom or not. But by a 5-judge bench, later in 1962, the Supreme Court took a view that the Supreme Court can segregate what is essential and what is not essential.
Okay.
And what is considered to be not the essential part of a religion, those practices can be interfered with by the Supreme Court.
All right.
So these are the issues that will come up before the Supreme Court today. Supreme Court will decide, the contours will map out what all the points that need to be pondered over by the 9 judges.
All right. Hold on to your thoughts there. Utkarsh, let me quickly introduce two other guests who are joining us on the show. Acharya Vikramaditya is a religious preacher, and Yogita Bayana, women's rights activist, is also with us here on the show. I'll come to both of you in just a bit. Let me first go across to Neetu and get a sense of what the perception down south is, considering, Neetu, this entire hearing that we're going to be seeing today in the Supreme Court has emanated from the fact that there has been so much controversy over the entry of women between 10 and 50 in the Sabarimala temple. I understand that even as far as the Sabarimala temple is concerned, they have voiced their opinion that they don't want this issue to become so contentious that it becomes violent, what we have seen in the past. And therefore, are we looking at some sort of a middle ground being taken on that count as well by the Sabarimala administration?
No, Now, see, what the Travancore Devasam Board has earlier also maintained is that the affidavit which they gave in the Supreme Court also stated that they are not in support of entry of women of all age groups. They said that the traditions of this temple should be followed. So that was a board stand earlier also. And when this order came in September 28, 2018, Padma Kumar, a former left MLA, was a CPM MLA, was the president then, and the left government was in power. So at that time, this, they had said in Supreme Court that they are duty bound to abide by the order. Now the government's view was very clear in the beginning itself. In both the affidavits that the left government had filed before the Supreme Court, they said that they are for the entry of women, they are for gender equality, but at the same time they had also asked Supreme Court to form a committee which also has experts from the Hindu religion, so they can look into all these aspects and give their report to the Supreme Court. They had asked the Supreme Court to consider this report before giving a final order. But when the verdict came, the state government went ahead and said that they will implement this order. But after this review petitions were referred to a larger bench, what we saw was a consistent was a change in the stand of state government. You can also attribute it to the amount of protests that we saw last time when this decision was to be implemented. So at that time, what the government said is that there is lack of clarity. So the Devasam minister went on record saying that if anybody wants police protection to enter the temple, let them go to Supreme Court and get this order and come, then we will provide protection according to the order. So that, that was a, there was a change of stand with the state government where they decided that they will tread cautiously this time. So even now, the state government is taking this wait and watch approach to see what this nine bench constitution will come out with.
I want to come to you, Acharya Vikramaditya, because as Utkarsh was pointing out, this is a larger question about whether the courts can even interfere in issues with regards to religion. Now, considering that the constitution itself allows everyone to practice their religion, but within the religion, you know, the, this is not a core issue of faith. This is related to the manner in which a practice is being conducted, which many view as being anti-women. Therefore, do you believe that the court has the right to step in, which it did earlier on?
If the practices are wrong, then the certainly court can. But we have to understand this is a traditional issue. This is an issue related with the centuries. The people are being followed. Or the tradition is being followed. And there is no harm in that. This is the problem which has been created by some activists. They are not the devotees. This is the fight between the devotees and the activists. They are not the devotees. Those who are fighting the, for the rights, they don't have any right because they are not the, they don't have a faith in that religion, that cult. If they have a faith, then they will have to follow the rules and regulation of the cult. If the, somebody is not following the rules and regulation of the specific cult religion, then it is not a he or she is not a follower of the religion. If you
Acharya Vikramaditya, some of these practices are formulated by a certain segment of people. Women perhaps were not even included in that decision making, whether women of the age of puberty should even be allowed to enter or not. What is the basis of this exclusion?
No, you have to understand this is a basic level of common sense. This is just like Vasudev Jaggi clearly said, this is a matter of common sense. You have a two toilets, that one is for ladies and one for gents. If the people start saying that I want to go in a lady toilet, not in a men's toilet,
but sir, these are not comparable situations.
No, why is it not comparable?
Why comparing it to a washroom? We are talking about a temple. We are talking treats everyone equally.
I am not comparing this issue with the toilet. I am saying this thing. This is a matter of just a common sense. This is a matter of a tradition. This is a matter of the faith in a specific religion. If you don't have a faith in the religion, then don't go to that religion. You can form your own religion. You can form your own cult.
Yogita
Why
Bhayana,
are you specifically
the very
disturbing the people who have a faith in that?
Yogita Bhayana,
just
just a second, Acharya Vikramaditya. Yogita Bhayana, Acharya Vikramaditya says that these women do not have faith and that is why they want to turn around an age-old practice. But many would say that they do have faith. That is why they want to visit the temple. temple and go and pay their obeisance to the god over there, despite the fact that they are being prohibited from going there?
See, first of all, Acharya Vikram Aditya has no right to judge that who's a devotee, who's not a devotee. You can't screen somebody's internal, you know, emotions that somebody is a devotee or non-devotee. Just, it is not activist versus devotees. They are not devotees. How can you say that those who are protesting the, against the entry are also devotees? So it is, you really can't, you know, decide. Okay. So, and also you are saying that women, if you don't allow, how will they have more faith? You know how?
Just go and read the judgment first. What the Hindu Malhotra said, clearly you are...
See, again, now you're coming... Okay, now you...
What the Hindu Malhotra said...
Only Hinduji you are quoting. How about the other ones? Only Hindu Malhotra ji went against it. No, what about the three other judges who were in the favor?
The other judges doesn't even have touched that issue.
No, you are wrong. Even she, only she, no, they have she not. Was the one who went against. So it's, it doesn't mean that one person. That's why we have five bench judges. That's why we have seven bench judges.
Where the judges have touched that.
Again, I also want to ask you one thing, one simple thing. It is not about faith versus law. It is about faith, men's faith versus women's faith. Understand that. Even women have right to faith, right to pray. So that's how. So now you want to believe the judgment of the quoting Hinduji, but you don't want to follow Supreme Court's instruction. You want to stone pelt women's there. You know, you want to be violent there. You just don't want to follow the law there.
People are following the court.
You are devotee. You are hitting the women there. You are creating violence-like situation. You are stopping women physically. That is devotion. So I really pity your devotion. I really don't think that can be a true devotion. You know. So you just can't say that who's a devotee, who's not a devotee.
All right.
About
let me take one point that has been made,
you know,
by Yogita Bhayana. Just hold on, ma'am. Let me go back to Utkarsh. Utkarsh, Yogita Bhayana is here making a point that this is not a question of faith versus law. This is a question of how faith is being perceived differently by two sets of people, men and women.
Maha, that may not be the end of it, because as I was earlier pointing out, there are certain temples in which men are also prohibited. We have similar temples in Hindu customs where men are prohibited. So the question in those cases would arise, again, the questions of gender bias, again, the questions of customs, traditions, questions of to what extent the Supreme Court can interfere in practices of religion.
Utkarsh, have those examples been quoted earlier when the arguments in the Sabarimala case were made of men not being allowed in certain temples?
Exactly. Yes, ma. Yes, all these arguments were quoted. These arguments were part of the judgment which was dealt with by the court in September 2018, also in November 2019. All these contentions were adjudicated upon by the Supreme Court when it decided initially that the doors of Sabarimala must be open to all women of all ages. And then in November last year, when the Supreme Court said that the issue can no longer confine only to Sabarimala, let the scope of this this adjudication be expanded so that a judicial policy can be evolved in the interest of consistency across all religions. The Supreme Court has taken note of the fact that similar petitions on Parsi fire temples, mosques, as well as in Daudi Bora community, all these petitions are pending. Not just that, the Santhara practice in Jains, in which you voluntarily give up to your food, you fast unto death, even that is also pending in the Supreme Court. All these issues will have to be dealt with by the Supreme Court at one point or another. So what the Supreme Court now wants to do is to evolve a judicial policy so that once those guidelines are set, once those parameters are set, the other benches, perhaps the bench of a 5-judge or the bench of a 3-judge, can follow the dictum derived by the 9-judge bench and can decide each and every case as and when it does arises.
So, you know, correct me if I'm wrong here, Utkarsh, but then largely the 9-judge bench that will be looking at these cases today is going to look at it from the prism of women's rights and not particularly, you know, law, faith versus law.
This has always been about women's rights. This has always been about right to equality. Because women are saying, those women who were here before the Supreme Court, they have been saying that if it's a public temple, if it's a place of worship which is public in nature, how can women be barred from entering that place based on their physiological conditions? Again, right to profess and propagate a religion, Article 25 and Article 26. What they are asserting in the Supreme Court is, can my right to pray be subservient to a man's right to pray, or can my right to pray be subject to regulations framed by a temple management or not?
Okay.
These are always questions of gender bias, gender equality, and also one of the foremost contentions, Maha, constitutional morality. It is not just about public morality, it is about constitutional morality. That issue will also need to be settled by the Supreme Court, whether Supreme Court has drawn a Lakshman Rekha for itself or not, when it decides issues based on constitutional morality.
Okay, Acharya Vikramaditya, taking on from there, if it's a question about constitutional morality, the Constitution says we are all equal before the law. Do you then think that this is a lost battle for the Sabarimala administration that does not want to make any tweaking to the tradition?
In that case, then the government of the India should perform, should make a uniform religious code. They should specifically donate this thing, each and everything. Then they have to decide, this is not good for the country, this is not for the religion. If you are saying this thing, that in the constitution, when the constitution was formed, they clearly said in the Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs. If they are giving the right to manage the religious affairs and the tradition which is being followed by the centuries.
But
if
one,
you are talking about the,
but
some,
one
some
right cannot impinge upon the other.
People,
you understand that as well, right?
No. This is not a violation of right. How can you say this is a case of gender inequality? A specific age people, do you have a separate temple for that? This is ladies Striyon ke liye alag se Sabarimala temple hai na? We have a separate temple for the ladies. Then you have a
Why
two
not
temples.
You go to the
and
temple,
this one
no,
specific
Vikram
temple,
Vikram.
You have a this. Pardon?
This specific temple is most visited in the entire world. You know that? If you should know that this particular temple you're talking about is the most visited
that,
one.
That is just because the devotees,
so
not because
we should
of
be deprived
like
of
Bhayana.
Listen.
That is just because of the devotees, they have a faith.
Okay, forget about me. Let the women
the
from down south go there.
Interest,
I don't want to go there. I'm very
things.
Clear. I don't want to go there. Let the women, those who really want to go, let them go now. I don't
need
I'm
not
to interested.
Then need not to argue.
Never.
Then why you are saying you're raising your voice.
That's exactly
you
what I'm
are
saying,
the people who have, don't have a faith in
and
the religion.
For the first time, I agree with you. That
I
uniform
know you, what
religious
kind of people
code,
you are.
Yes,
you are
it should
just
be
a
there.
Religious,
even men should
the
fight there.
Of,
they are not allowed.
Just
who's
for the
stopping
sake of publicity,
them
you are raising this issue.
Who's stopping them
you are the
court and ask for rights where they are not allowed?
I'm clearly saying this thing. Each and every person of this country know this thing.
Okay, don't
get personal. Just raising this issue.
We are not here to get personal.
Just for the media coverage. Just for the media coverage.
That's the reason
you are
we don't want.
The
I don't want to go. I'm okay. I don't want to go. I'm talking
the
about the larger
people.
Picture. Those
you
who
are
really
saying
want
this
to
thing.
Go.
If you are not a devotee, then why you are intervening
down,
this thing?
Vikram Ditya,
you,
calm
you
down.
You don't have any interest in these things. I am
calm
a very
down,
specific
Mr. Vikram Ditya. You can talk normally.
In
you don't have
things.
To shout.
You don't have
you
any.
You don't have to shout.
I am not talking about a nonsense thing.
You don't have to shout.
Which is happening in these people in this country. You are
okay,
you
can
people,
calm down and talk.
You,
we are having a sensible debate. You really don't have to shout.
No, I'm not shouting.
Don't
you
get
are basically
personal.
Unnecessary.
Let's talk
you have,
the
don't
issue
have an interest
out.
In the Sabarimala. No. If you don't have a any faith
I don't
in the
have
region,
interest,
then why
means
you
I have interest in women's
I
equality.
Have,
I'm fighting for my
I
women
have
folks.
I will have to intervene here.
If you're not a devotee,
I will have to intervene here. Just a second.
If you're not a devotee, then why you are arguing?
One second. Acharya Vikramaditya. One second. Now help us understand the basis on which you believe that women of a certain age should not be allowed there. What is there any scientific basis for this? Because earlier on the argument that was made is that there is a scientific basis for it. What is it?
No, that was just a religious story which is behind that. It is just a religious story. Just because jo wahan ke jo mukhya
story can
Swami
be a
ji
bias.
The,
let him finish. Let him finish.
Need
I'll
not
come to you.
The story. The cult, all the cults
okay.
are just
okay.
because of the stories.
Okay.
Go ahead.
All the religions are just because of the
make
stories.
Your point. Okay.
Because of these stories. If they, you have to understand the whole story, basically, ये जो बात उठी कि specific age की जो स्त्रियां होती हैं उनके menstruation के लिए बात, ये बात बिल्कुल गलत है, ये बात कहीं नहीं उठी थी वहां केवल सबरीमाला के अंदर स्पेसिफिकली जब उन्होंने एक कथा उठती है कि वहां कथा के अंतर्गत उन्होंने कहा कि मैं उस स्पेसिफिकली स्त्री को नहीं देखूंगा एक पर्टिकुलर एज के अंदर जब उन्होंने विवाह के लिए बात करी तो केवल मातृत्व भाव के अंतर्गत वहां पर यह बात ली गई कि उनका दर्शन आज से उन्होंने निषेध किया तो उनका एक सेपरेटली मंदिर बना दिया गया तो इस कथा को केवल साइंटिफिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से आप जोड़ना चाहते हैं ये बात गलत तरह से जोड़ी गई केवल मेंस्ट्रुएशन के लिए
तो ये यही सवाल तो ये जो आपकी दूसरी गेस्ट है हमारी वो उठा रही हैं कि जो प्रैक्टिसेस चली आ रही हैं या जिन स्टोरीज पे वो बेस्ड हैं उसमें भी बायसेस हो सकते हैं ना इस बात को तो देखना बनता है
नो बाय आप ये कहना चाहते आप ये कहना चाह रहे हैं कि धर्म बदल दें धर्म ही बदल देते हैं आप सती वाज नॉट द नॉट नॉट द ट्रेडिशन सती वाज सती सती वाज नॉट अ ट्रेडिशन सती सती वाज नॉट सती वाज नॉट द रिलीजियस प्रैक्टिस
इट वाज आल्सो अ कल्ट
यू हैव जस्ट करेक्ट योर नॉलेज करेक्ट Miss Bhayana, correct your knowledge first. Don't say the sati was a tradition. Sati was the not a religious practice.
You are the most knowledgeable, Mr. Vikram.
Sati was not a religious practice.
It was cult.
I know how what kind of knowledge you have. If you are introducing the sati,
you are the one who started.
Sati was practiced in this country just because of the Muslim invasion. Just because of the Muslim invasion.
All right, all right. Let's leave it at that. Let's leave it at that. Yogita Bhayana, Acharya Vikramaditya, both of you, many thanks for joining us. Many thanks to Neetu and Utkarsh as well. Let's wait for the 9-judge bench to decide on this matter, whether it's a matter of faith versus law or whether it's a matter of women's right to pray and equality before law. That is something that the court will take a call on today. With that, we're taking a very quick break. For more on that, you can also log on to our website, news18.com.